up, everybody? Today we are tying a double ugly, an articulated streamer pattern. We're utilizing these trailer hitch hooks, which are pretty slick for doing articulated flies. You got your back hook and your trailer hitch here, and that's going to hook right on there, so it makes life pretty easy. So we'll start this fly just with the back hook mounted in our vise. I'm using a little thicker thread, 140 denier. And we're basically just tying two woolly buggers with a little extra to it. So I'm just going to start my thread about 3/4 up the way. And we're going to put some yellow marabou. So I want to that tail to be about the length of the hook shank. Something like that. Then I can measure that there. And we're going to tie it down kind of up here towards the front and cinch that down all the way out the back there. Now we can clip off this excess. And let's repeat that step with the olive marabou. Kind of measure the length of the hook shank there. Once we get that measurement, let's bring our thread back here. It just creates kind of a bulky underbody there. There we go. Now we got a nice fluffy two-toned tail out the back. All right, now what we need is let's put a little flash in the tail there. I'm just going to use a gold flashaboo. And let's just do one strand on each side, just a couple of little stripes in there, pretty subtle. So I'm just going to hold it on this side of the hook, secure it in, and then double it over onto the opposite side. And so now I've got a couple strands out the back there. Okay, now we're going to take either some just regular old woolly bugger hackle, or I do have a little bit of this schlappin that'll make it way buggier. So I'm just going to take the tip there and come back slightly from the tip and secure that feather in there at the back. Just make advance forward just a little bit, make sure I get that secured in there. I'm just going to use this cactus chenille here. And we'll attach that there in the same spot. Make sure that's secured in there. And now we can advance our thread to the eye of the hook. Notice I didn't crowd my head there. I want to keep this eye fairly open. These trailer hitches have a nice wide eye, so that it'll swim freely. Okay, now we can go over the top away from us with the crystal chenille and wrap forward, creating the body of the fly. Hold that with our right hand, drop our thread over with our left hand about 3 times, and now I can snip off the excess. Let's just make a few good turns there, just make sure that's secured in there. Okay, now let's take our feather here, our hackle, and we'll wrap that over the top away from us going forward. Now again, these feathers are pretty webby. You can kind of comb them out as you wrap forward just to get those feathers laying back like that. Hold that straight up in the air with our right hand, drop our thread over with our left hand about 3 times, and that secures in. And let's just kind of clean up that eye just slightly. Okay, so I'm going to take two strands of just some barred rubber legs here that I have, and nice and long, so they'll hang along the side of the fly there. So let's, and I'll keep the front there because I'm going to double these back over. So let's secure those in on one side, and then we'll double them back over onto the other side, and then we can secure those down. Okay, so now we're ready to attach the trailer hitch, so it's very simple. All we do is just attach it there, take it out of the vise, and remount it right there. Now we'll reattach our thread on the trailer hitch here. Now we need to close that hitch a little bit there, so I just take my finger right here and push down as I come up. Oops. Push down as I come up with my thread there, and I can close that down with a little muscle there and just make some good tight wraps up that. Secure that down. And then it's a good idea just to put a little dab of super glue there just to keep that thread from slipping around like that. Okay, now we're going to basically just repeat the steps that we did on the back fly, and we'll do the same on the front. We need to tie in our eyeballs, so I've got some just dumbbell eyes here. I'm going to secure those just about an eye length back from the eye of the hook. So I just make one wrap there, and then we'll figure eight it two or three times. Now, I actually prefer these eyes on the underside of this particular fly. I'm just going to flip it over once I got them in there, secured. Make some good figure eight wraps there. We'll make sure we put a little dab of glue there. Keep those from slipping around on us. Make sure they're in position like that.